Life is made up of moments. Most are inconsequential. But there's one or two that will define us. When your life looks like it's heading in one direction, or that one moment takes it down a different path, if you seize it, that moment can take you back to the top, to a stage you've lit up before. That moment can help you say the perfect goodbye, or get you somewhere you never thought possible. That moment can change your club's future forever, and take you to the greatest league in the world. Today, that moment will come. And when it does, will you be ready?
Well, it is a game that has been dubbed the richest prize in football, and this year the prize on offer was the biggest yet, with an estimated £120 million going to whoever could claim that final place in the Premier League next season. With Cardiff and Hull already there, would it be Crystal Palace or Watford at the top table of English football next season? Your commentators here at Wembley Stadium are Don Goodman and First Bill Leslie.
Let's run you through the two lineups then. Julian Speroni, the only Palace survivor from their last playoff campaign. That was 5 years ago now. Ian Holloway goes for the same side here that blunted Brighton in both legs of the semi-final. The defence marshalled by Danny Gabidon, who's only come into the side in the last half a dozen games or so. The shield in front of them, provided by skipper Mili Jedinak and South African international Hagisho Dikashoy. Wilfred Zaha, well, he will invariably be a focal point today. He signs off at Palace and, importantly, fit to play after an ankle injury. Jonathan Williams, another prodigiously talented academy product, again asked to play on the left behind Aaron Wilbraham, without a goal since August last year, leading the line. Manuel Almunia in the Watford goal, as the former Arsenal man has been for most of the season. Watford have changed personnel a bit, but very rarely systems. This afternoon, their back three is made up of long-serving Lloyd Doyley, Joel Ekstrand and Marco Cassetti, two of the on-loan Udinese party in this lineup. Their lone players have attracted plenty of attention, and there are four more in the midfield, including Nathaniel Shalabar, the 18-year-old England under 21 international on loan from Chelsea. Troy Deeney, top scorer, and Matej Vidra, championship player of the season of the front two. 42 goals between them this season. Kevin Phillips, three times a playoff runner-up on the bench for Palace. A former Watford man, of course. Watford have a former Eagle among their substitutes, Fitz Hall, who can't get back in their side at the moment after injury. The Golden Boys, Watford, kick us off. They finished in third over the course of the season, up against the Crystal Palace side, that finished two places behind them. Here's the Czech international Pudel, his compatriot Vidra. Shalabar.
I'll keep your eye on that. Like I said before, he does get a lot of the ball. Shalabar knows that Anya wants to get forward on that right-hand side, and he will try and pick him out.
Gets Anya to it, touched on by Dikashoy. A challenge from Ekstrand was a little too keen, and inside the first 10 minutes, the men in yellow pick up their first yellow.
Well, it's the last thing he needed, isn't it? Defender, 10 minutes in. On a yellow card, and when you go to ground like that and lunge and you don't get the ball and you get the man, look at Martin Atkinson's position, absolutely perfect, and Ekstrand can't have any complaints about seeing a yellow card for that.
Gianfranco Zola brought his side here yesterday afternoon, and the Italian was pacing around the pitch, measuring out the distances, very much of the feeling that it was a large pitch that his side could and should enjoy. Well done here for Crystal Palace, that's why we'll have a break in play for treatment.
Dikashoy, important player. Just gives Ian Holloway a moment just to one or two moments with his team. They haven't had a lot of luck with injuries, have they? Crystal Palace, Ben Murray, and now Dikachoy. 15 minutes into the game, and one of their key players has been lost to them. Highly unfortunate.
And you would expect, looking at their bench, that they will not look to change the system, send on Stuart O'Keefe. Former South End player would be the roundest peg in the round hole vacated, if you like, by Kagiso Dikachoy. But this is a player who has not played a lot of football, just two substitute appearances since early February. Came on in the 90th minute against Brighton in the second leg. That was one of those appearances. Here he is, taking to the field. His first playoff campaign, his first visit at Wembley. Zaha. His England under 21 colleague Chalabari shaking him off. It's a very tiny cutback to Garvan, and that is superb defending by Mr. Watford, Lloyd Doyley.
Well, it is, but the signs are there, aren't they, for Watford? They're just letting Wilfried Zaha get on the ball and run at the defenders. That's a dangerous game to play.
Here he is again, Zaha. Another bit of trickery, it's not away. Anya there in the nick of time ahead of Williams. Here's Moxie, just hooks it back in, hopefully. Jedinak. It's got the Palace fans going, this latest passage of play, but careful of first there, Balladier.
Yeah. And Watford needed him. Just the reliable came up trumps, didn't he? Zaha again, too strong for the Watford players. Mixing out Garvan, and look who's there. Lloyd Doyley on top of Owen Garvan in a flash to get the block in. It's good defending.
Edinak could be in trouble here. Martin Atkinson has a card out.
And again, Crystal Palace skipper knew, didn't he? What was coming? Blatant. Another combative player goes straight into Abdi there. Nowhere near the ball. And there again, Almunia. Forced to kick the ball long. Not part of the profile, not part of the plan to get Watford to the Premier League. Something needs to change for them.
As a manager can get your opponents to do things they're not used to doing, then that is going to be a cause for satisfaction. This is Anya, who does exactly what he usually does.
First time, isn't it? You saw there the pace, the energy of Anya. Watford need him to put that more to better use.
Anya lets it run. Here's Vidra. Puda. Hawk looking for Deeney. That was perhaps as good as Watford have created so far.
Should have been maybe having a shot there, Troy Deeney. But Mila Jedinak spoke about how combative a player he is, and he can be. We saw it in the semi-final. Often leads with the arms. And he's already been booked. And look at that, right across Chalabar's face. And that is a dangerous game to play.
Hogg is the runner from midfield here. Abdi. Vidra leaves it for Deeney. Oh, it's come to Matic Vidra! Brilliant. There's a goal-saving challenge from Damien Delaney.
Outstanding. We saw Lloyd Doyley make a similar block, didn't we? This is important. Delaney knows that he's got to throw himself and get the block in here. And that's wonderful defending. Really is. Closest, biggest chance yet.
Zaha. When he has got on the ball, has invariably made things happen. Doyle has taken it away from him there. And Martin Atkinson brings a very cagey first half of this playoff final to a close. The standout moments provided by Wilfried Zaha, but barely an effort on target from either side. Both players with injury. Matej Vidra not looking good. Kagoshoy Dikashoy has already departed the scene for Crystal Palace. But at Wembley, half-time, Crystal Palace 0, Watford 0. Matej Vidra, who is the Championship player of the season. He might have been out of form up until the second leg of the playoff semi-final against Leicester, but he is off. That ankle injury he picked up when Damian Delaney blocked his shot means he will play no further part, and the Spanish striker Alex Hejo comes on for Watford. No further changes for Crystal Palace. Already had one substitution forced on them with the calf injury to Kagoshoy Dikashoy. Well, if the first half was posturing, sizing each other up, just jabbing, looking for weaknesses, now we are down to the real business. 45 minutes, one of these two clubs away from the Premier League or from another season in the Championship.
Interesting to see, isn't it, if the game stays the same for the next 15 minutes or so, if Ian Holloway does adopt that tactic, bringing Yannick Bolasie off the bench with all that pace. He's a player that I would imagine could cause Watford defenders problems. You've got Zaha on one side, and the first half was almost a replica from a Crystal Palace perspective of what happened in the second leg away at Brighton. So far so good for Ian Holloway.
Certainly you do get the feeling, don't you, Don, that Crystal Palace have done pretty much exactly what their manager has asked them to do. Watford have been far from their usual expressive selves.
He learned, didn't he, from the first half at Vicarage Road, where they were nearly blown out of the water, Crystal Palace. They knew they couldn't afford to be giving Watford a start to build Watford's confidence up. They couldn't allow them time and space on the ball, and they've carried out that plan absolutely perfectly so far. From Watford perspective, you can only imagine that they can only improve. Passing needs to be much, much better. And this is what we didn't see in the first half. Defenders getting the ball off the goalkeeper. I wonder if that's something that Gianfranco Zola has addressed at half-time.
They usually play at a much higher tempo as well, yeah. Don't they, Watford?
They do. They haven't been able to get up and running. They've not really enjoyed any sustained periods of passing in the first half.
Kevin Phillips, an ominous presence so far as opponents are concerned on the bench there. Yannick Bolasie, you can see. Peter Ramage as well. Watford enjoying their best spell in the match, though. Hejo at the heart of it. Poodle into the box. It's a fair challenge. It's a risky one. It had to be perfect. Now, Wilbraham is onside here. Can he get away from Cassetti? A cut back from Wilbraham, and Watford had men back. Yeah. That's rather crude by Abdi. Wanted advantage play, but it's been pulled back for a free kick. And, well, that is a far from intelligent thing to do there from O'Keefe, to fire the ball straight at the stricken Watford player.
Well, let me tell you, the stricken Watford player is making an absolute meal of that. I've got no doubt Armin Abdi needs to get up. He's been cynical, he's brought the Palace player down, he's making the most of that. And he's angry. Oh look, all of a sudden he's alright, look. That's where players really let themselves down, but it's O'Keefe bundled over, look. And he goes to ground, the referee blows his whistle there, and then O'Keefe just hits the ball. I mean, it hits him. I mean, that's not going to hurt him, that really does not hurt. silly.
Well, we've seen already it's a match where little things will most probably make the difference. Cool heads high on the agenda in terms of one of the decisive factors here potentially, and the captain has a calming word with the young man introduced during the first half to replace the injured Kagiso Dikachoy. I think he's going to go into the book as well as Almanati. No surprise for that.
It's just petulance, that's all it is. He needs to stay calm now. There's another player on a yellow card. What a chance Aaron Wilbraham had, though.
Garver. Shalabar got it away. Williams. Hoisted in by Moxie. Cassetti away. Not enough distance on it, though. O'Keefe.
Oh, we've come to life, haven't we? It's taken a while, but all of a sudden, feels like we've got situations evolving where somebody will have an opportunity to make that all-important breakthrough. And this is a game where we know how frequently first goal wins it. 9 out of the last 10, I think.
Ian Holloway's Blackpool, though, one of those that bucked that trend.
Ironically, yeah.
Well, in the space of 30 seconds, really, we had two flashpoints, as much of which as really has proceeded in the previous hour. Penalty shout at one end as far as Watford were concerned, and at the other end, what a glorious chance for Aaron Wilbraham. Sure, as a Palace fan, many a Palace fan in here wondering, what if that was Glenn Murray? Garland with the free kick. Oh, a slip there from Cassetti, almost provided an opening.
Well, Delaney's headed this down into a really good area. He's got to really expect one of his teammates to be making a gamble, but look, he knocks it back. Nobody really, other than Wilbraham, trying to get in, but we've got a game now. Watford felt they should have had a penalty there. He just nicks the ball, Poodle, over Gabidon. Went down way too easily. Palace break up the other end. Bends his run perfectly, Aaron Wilbraham, and this is where it has to be ruthless. Has to be ruthless. At the very least, Almunia needs to be making some kind of a save.
That's Delaney. Jedinak. Zaha is onside. Has the experienced Cassetti with him. Still Zaha. Had the chance to play it earlier. Oh, here's O'Keefe! What a save from Manuel Almunia.
Well, there you go. 65 minutes on the clock, and a goalkeeper is seriously called into question for the first time. It's wonderful play. Zaha feeds the ball across. Great skill from O'Keefe to make the space. He hits it just hard. It's one of those head down. He puts his foot through it, but the goalkeeper's equal to it.
Well, Stuart O'Keefe, when you have never scored a senior goal, that's what you do. You give it everything. And the experienced Almunia covering his near post. Jonathan Williams comes off. Listen to that. Kevin Phillips comes on. Three times a playoff finalist, three times a playoff loser. He will tell you he started the previous three. The pattern is different this time, coming off the bench. Almunia called. Deeney took it out of his hands. Oh, they've left it! Wilbraham! What a mistake from Watford. That was so nearly so costly. They're not out of the woods yet. Almunia scoops it behind.
Well, it took a while to boil up to the boil and simmer, didn't it? But we have got a game now. That's terrible. Cassetti and Pudel, they just allow the ball to go through Wilbraham. Any kind of a dink. Get the ball in the air and he scores. Credit Almunia.
Almunia's come, hasn't got there. Watford are at sixes and sevens. Danny Gabidon knows that was a glorious chance for him to punish them for it.
Oh, set pieces, they have been vulnerable again. Remind ourselves, David Nugent a header from a free kick, a header from a corner. We're seeing why.
Kevin Phillips well marshalled there. Don't leave it loose in the box with him around, though.
Defensively, Watford are all over the place. They really are.
What's happened, Don? Why has it happened? Why have they gone like this?
Well, they haven't been put under that much pressure, even though they hadn't hit the heights in terms of their passing and their movement, but all of a sudden, Crystal Palace, credit to Wilbraham, his movement has been clever. O'Keefe, good little piece of footwork to it, allowing a little bit of space to get the strike. And there's more injury concern.
Looks like another ankle injury to another striker, which gives us time, Don, just to dwell on the fact that Ian Holloway's side are really starting to get themselves on top.
Well, you see it there, right there. That is basically how the game's panned out in the last 10 minutes. And it is Manuel Almunia who is being asked all of the questions in this game. And so far, he's come up trumps with the answers. Lovely skill from O'Keefe. Hard and low, hard for a goalkeeper, but his angles are good. And then a terrible mix-up. And he's on top of Wilbraham. And he makes a really good save. Nearly undid all his good work, didn't he, when he goes, doesn't get anywhere near that ball. And Gabidon can't take advantage of that, but hairy, hairy moments if you're a Watford supporter.
Is it the day that Kevin Phillips gets the happy ending to his playoff story at the age of 39 years?
Against his first club.
Garvin, here's Wilbraham, Doyle is in there to take it away.
Absolutely brilliant defending.
Zaha now to come across to have his go down Palace's left.
Well, one mistake now. Could be terminal.
Wilbraham has come off Doyle. Oh, Garvin!
That really is one of those, either side. And that's not a very good challenge, is it?
I think Ward will see a yellow card for that one. He would expect to, certainly. And indeed does. Calculated risk, Don?
It is, really. Yeah, he knew exactly what he was doing. Cynical. He was never going to let Poodle get the other side of him.
Zaha. Zaha, he's got it through to Wilbraham again. Almunia is his equal.
Well, he must wonder, Aaron Wilbraham, he must wonder what he's got to do to score, because he doesn't do anything wrong here. Absolutely no question. Clever movement, finds the space. One touch, gets the ball away quickly before Doyle can get the blocking. And it's straight at Almunia, who makes another decent save.
Nearly out of time now, these two. Moritz. He's got a decent cross in, Kevin Phillips.
A little bit of lack of communication there, end of the game.
So Manuel Almunia, at the age of 36, is the hero for Watford over the piece in keeping them in it.
We're heading into extra time. Mourinho looking absolutely captivated by this one. Stand by, though. It's going to be decided either in the next 30 minutes or by a penalty shooter. Let's rejoin Don Goodman and Bill Leslie.
Well, I'm sure Jose Mourinho knows that for the first time in 11 years, extra time required to decide the Championship playoff final. The first time since it's reverted to its natural home here at Wembley Stadium. Norwich and Birmingham City, the last two sides to require it 11 years ago.
Whether Watford can finally get a period in the game where they can impose themselves and play the game the way they want to. I didn't recognise them in that 90 minutes. Certainly by far and away the worst they've played in the several games that I've seen them this season. unlucky for me still to be in this game.
Rossieri, ready for the run of Cassetti. Offered appeal for a handball decision that isn't going to come. What we do know is that both sides have used their three substitutes. Forestieri, one of those for Watford. He's wrestled away well.
There's that just lack of quality. The final pass, the final cross, the final shot. It's been the theme so far for Gianfranco Zola's team. His tactical plan should have worked, shouldn't it? Should have taken at least one of those chances.
Have come an awful long way. Both sides finishing in the bottom half of the table more often than not over recent seasons. It's a rare foray to the top half actually under Sean Dyche last season when they did finish 11th. Crystal Palace have finished below 15th for the last 4 years. It's been a tremendous turnaround. The upheaval of losing managers as well, changing managers. Holloway this week's been talking about the difficulty of taking over a side that is in good form, unbeaten in 11 and third in the table when he took over.
It is a rarity, isn't it, that scenario.
It brings its own set of challenges, which is perhaps one of the reasons they did lose form. Well, this could come to Deeney! What a save that was! How on earth did Giulio Speroni keep Troy Deeney at bay?
Well, that is an unbelievable hand to save his team, it really is. Remind ourselves of the save he made at the Amex against Brighton. Miraculous reflexes. There's another one.
Wood gives chase. Watford will have the throw, but yet again, the Argentinian, nearly a decade at the club, is the main man for Palace.
Oh, Joel Ward almost presents itself, but the change of direction, the spring, Abdi with the ball in. Watch the way Speroni just springs to his left and gets a really strong palm on it. That's outstanding goalkeeping.
Away from Jedinak.
He's done really well, Jedinak, you know, because there have been times where you could see he's wanted to throw himself into challenges, the Crystal Palace skipper, but he's managed to keep his discipline and not go to ground. Can't run the risk of seeing a second yellow.
Phillips to Zaha. Still Zaha. Oh, there's a risky challenge. And there is a penalty. Wilfried Zaha took on Cassetti, who took the bait. He's booked. But that is the least of Watford's worries.
Well, most people say he was unfortunate in the semi-final second leg to concede a penalty against Leicester. But once again, totally outwitted, outfoxed. He's making a challenge in the penalty area that is always going to be a real gamble, and he's just dropped his team right in it. Poor defending. He's had a bad afternoon.
Manuel Almunia, who bailed out Marco Cassetti against Leicester City, can he do it here in the final at Wembley against Kevin Phillips of all people? The club where it all started for him professionally, Kevin Phillips, is put to the sword by the master craftsman, Kevin Phillips, at Wembley in the dying minutes of the first period of extra time. That just might be the one to send Palace back to the Premier League.
Well, if you want anyone in the world to have this moment, not to panic, to stay calm, to hit the back of the net in a place where no goalkeeper in the world is going to save it, then step forward, Kevin Phillips. Never, ever in any doubt. That was an emphatic penalty. And look what it means. Now they can reach out and touch the Barclays Premier League. 15 minutes, and they are there.
Well, we asked the question earlier on, Don. Is this to be the day that the Kevin Phillips story, the extraordinary story that it is, starting off in non-league football at Baldock Town, just to the north of Watford, gets the happiest of endings? And maybe at the age of 40, he will be playing in the Premier League one more time.
Certainly not over yet for Watford. So much ability out there, but they're going to have to find something that they haven't managed to do so far.
Well, the first period of extra time is certainly over, and the Crystal Palace supporters are celebrating like it is already over. They're going to be a long 15 minutes to go for them, but given the way that the match has gone so far, you would not bank against that man's contribution being enough, Don.
Well, what a story. What a story. Cassetti, all afternoon long, has got his defending wrong against Wilfred Zaha. Look at Martin Atkinson's position. Perfect refereeing position. Clear penalty. And he gets it spot on, and look at Zaha. He knows. He knows who's going to take it. That's why I think he's celebrating like that. Because when this fella steps up, never, ever any danger. There is not a goalkeeper in the world that would have stopped that absolute rocket into the roof of the net.
It's an aerial bombardment now for the side who usually favour the more intricate approach. Ball in by Batocchio. Real chance here for Ekstrand, who appeals for the penalty. Waved away and over by Abdi.
Oh, Martin Atkinson again was in the perfect place. It looks like Joel Ward. They didn't deal with a cross. Ward dives out. It hits him in the stomach. And we'll see from here. Comes out, closes that down, hits him right in the stomach. And the follow-up was poor. Well, he's claiming, but more in desperation than anything else. And another piece of danger has been seen off for them. Last minute, and we'll see just how long there is to go.
Hey-ho, out by Jedinak. It's getting increasingly frantic as Hey-ho tries to bulldoze a route through. Forestieri, still Forestieri! Oh, off the line by Ward, would you believe it?
Wow, first piece of real quality from Watford going forward.
Have they left it too late? Hey-ho, a cross goal wouldn't fall for Deeney. And listen to that cheer as Speroni makes the catch.
Wow, was that their moment? That is wonderful skill from Forestieri, trying to bend it in the far corner. Is it Joel Ward that gets back in? It's a fantastic effort. And look at that. And that really epitomises Crystal Palace and their defensive performance here this afternoon. They've been exceptional to a man. They really, really have.
Seconds away now, Crystal Palace. Seconds away from the big prize. Right, Deeney thought he'd done enough. It's deflected off a Palace defender wide.
Oh, that deflection of Gabidon. Mayer took it into his own net, but this really is last chance saloon for Watford now.
One corner, one chance. It must be a goal for Watford. It's a Gabidon clearance.
Well, Mooney is up from the goal as well. We've had drama, haven't we, in the Football League, but surely we can't get any more.
The 122nd minute of the match. Forestieri, there is no time for Watford. It's the Premier League for Crystal Palace again. The exuberance of youth
the coolness of experience, Zaha and Phillips combine, and after 8 long years away, Crystal Palace are back. Ian Holloway, sheer delight from him. These are special, special moments for a club that 3 years ago was threatened with extinction.
Well, I don't think anybody that has watched that spectacle can deny they deserved it. It's so painful, isn't it, for the loser. This place, Wembley, it is not a place for losers. It really, really isn't. It's hurtful, but look, the joy. Kevin Phillips against his first professional club has come up trumps, and look what it means. Unbelievable.
Wilfried, many congratulations. Just sum up how you're feeling right now.
I'm speechless. I'm exhausted and speechless. I don't even know what to say. My dream come true, basically. This is all I wanted. I'm happy to leave Palace now, knowing that they're a Prem now.
We know your future lies at Manchester United next season, but how desperate were you to help Crystal Palace to the Premier League before you go there?
That's all I wanted, really. This game, I just told myself I'm giving it all I can. I'm giving it 100%, 200%, because I've been at Palace for so long, and all I want to do is help out the team, really, and I'm glad we've actually made it to the Prem.
Kevin, congratulations. Was this game made for you to come on and score the winner?
I don't know, it's fourth time lucky. It's my fourth playoff final, I've lost three, and just delighted to just get that feeling. I came here with Birmingham in the Carling Cup, never got on the pitch and won. It was an amazing feeling, but to come on, get the winning goal against the club where it all started 20 years ago, it's a fairy tale ending, and you know, I'm delighted for this lad. He goes with everyone's best wishes. 10 years at this club, he deserves every success that he gets in the future, but we'll enjoy this occasion, I certainly will.
Having watched most of the game from the bench, did you feel that you'd done enough in the 90 minutes to win it?
Yeah, we did. I thought we certainly deserved to win the game. We created good chances. Their keepers pulled off some great saves. But, you know, when it goes to extra time, it becomes a lottery. Players are tired, cramps setting in. But the lads were magnificent today. And you saw the way they defended in the last few minutes there. And overall, certainly deserved to win the game. And, you know, from my experience, you've got to enjoy occasions like this. And I'm sure the lads will tonight.
Looked like a nerveless penalty to me. What was it like standing up for it?
I felt confident. I wanted to take it. I had in my mind where I was going to take it. Never changed your mind, and I just thought, smash it. Delighted to see it fly in the top corner, and delighted to have scored at the old Wembley, now scored at the new Wembley. And if that is my last game, then what a way to sign off.
Wilfried, an 82,000 crowd at Wembley. Can you get used to playing in games like this?
I'm going to be honest. It's just walking into the stadium with so many people is just amazing, and being able to play in such a great ground is just, I don't know, I'm just speechless, man, and this is all I wanted.
Paddy McCarthy, who injured himself before the start of the season, he's the club captain. 1989 they did it, 1997 they did it, 2004, now 2013. No one has won as many playoff finals as Crystal Palace have. They have done it again. For the first time since 2005, they're back among the top 20. They have their hands on the resources that so many clubs only dreamed of. Back from the brink of oblivion through administration 3.5 years ago. This is a date that will always be etched in Crystal Palace history. May the 27th, 2013, Crystal Palace, glad all over.
Yeah, it's incredible. I'm feeling so many things at the moment, but most of all, just very proud of my team and my teammates for making this all possible.
How was it getting through this game? Because you picked up an injury early in the second half, didn't you?
Yeah, I went over on the ankle, sort of trying to run it off, got through it, and I don't think you could have brought me. I think you would have to drag me off, to be honest with you. But, yeah, like I said, a great team effort today, and that's what's got us the victory today, I think.
Did you think that you deserved it over the 90 minutes?
Look, it was a tight game. I think overall we just shaded it. You know, we had some good chances in the second half. And, you know, the keeper made some great saves. I'm speechless, mate. Honestly, I'm speechless. It's incredible.
Glenn, congratulations. How does this feel for you today?
Oh, it's absolutely amazing. I mean, this is what you play all those years for as a child, and obviously trying to become a professional, and then these are the rewards you get at the end of the day.
Was it tough for you to watch this today?
It was frustrating, and Yeah, I mean, the boys there got us where we needed to be honest, and I thought they were the best team throughout.
Your goals got Crystal Palace where you needed to be this season. How proud are you of this season that you've had?
Not only of that, but I mean, the group that we've got, I'm so proud to be amongst that group. I think we've come from the bottom right to the top. Obviously, we're relegation candidates, lost our manager, and throughout all that, we've still got here today.
Joel, congratulations. Is it sunk in what you've done today?
Not, to be honest, it hasn't yet. Just looking forward to it. You know, it's a dream come true. And, you know, the lads have worked so hard this year. And everyone's played their part, you know, from the backroom staff to the starting 11 and the guys on the bench or the guys who were injured, you know, everyone's played their part this season. So, you know, we're just going to stay in this moment and just treasure it.
Big contribution from you late in extra time. Just talk us through that goal line clearance.
You know, I just thought I'd get on the line. You know, it looked like he was going to have a shot, and to be honest with you, I was just in the right place at the right time, and, you know, I'm just thankful that I was there.
Julian, what does it mean to you to be back in the Premier League?
It means a lot to me. It means a lot to me. That's what every player wants to be, and we did it.
You've been at this club a long time now. What does it mean to the club to be a Premier League team again?
Well, everything for us. You know, when you have a taste of the Premier League, you want to be there. There's nowhere else you want to be. So we deserve it. Look, you know, look how they're enjoying this time, because we worked so hard, as Joel said before. We worked so hard this season, and I think we all deserve it.
Gianfranco, people often talk about this being the worst game to lose. How tough is this moment for you?
It is tough for me, but it is tough for everyone connected to Watford. What can I say? It hasn't certainly been our best game, but to lose extra time for a penalty, it's hard to take. To be fair, they played well. Probably they deserve, in the 90 minutes, they deserve something more than us. So congratulations to them, and they played very well. And it was unfortunate, because we had some players, important players like Vidra, that they were not sure to play today, and then towards the end of the first half had a problem with their ankle, so he had to come off. And you know, to lose a player like Matia wasn't good. On the other side, they had Zaha that today, honestly, was on a different level, and it made a difference. So when you play games like this, they're very tight. The difference can be made by the individual qualities, and today was the case.
Well, Ian, now you've had a few moments for it to sink in. Can you take on board the achievement that you've done today?
No, the longer it goes on, the better it'll feel. Obviously, having experienced it before is great, and the other side of things is not quite so good, but I'm just delighted, really. It's a vastly improved size of thing than it was last time, but how fortunate am I to have two groups that managed to do that for me, and I'm very, very pleased.
Just tell us what this means for the club as a whole.
It's impossible to put into words, you know. That prize is getting bigger and bigger, and if you don't get it, then the fair play things kicks in now, and you're not going to have a realistic chance to actually catch up with the people at the top of the game. And you know, for us, we've got some big plans, and the people who took over, they did it very unique club with four owners, and they deserve all sorts of credit. But you know, as I say, we're going to enjoy tonight first. We've got a party plan, whatever. It was either going to be a party or a wake, but and tonight I'm sure it'll be a party. But, you know, I also want to say well done to Watford and Gianfranco. I mean, talk about dignity, the way his team played, it was always there and it was always going to be that. And I'm just very, very relieved to have done it. So good luck to him, and good luck to them.
Well, for Ian Holloway, it is a second playoff promotion in the last 4 years. For Kevin Phillips, if that is the end of his career, what a way to bow out. And for the Eagles, 3 years after they emerged from the gloom of administration in the sunshine here at Wembley, they're heading back to the Premier League. Your last chance, last summer, your last day. Your own drummer. Go on fighting. Go on, yeah. Brace yourself. Brace yourself. Brace yourself. Brace yourself.
play and I want to try and experience winning.
The team never disappointed me, so I'm quite confident they will be all right.
Manuel Almunia is the hero for Watford over the piece in keeping them in it. Kevin Phillips, that just might be the one to send Palace back to the Premier League. It's the Premier League for Crystal Palace again.